Hey guys, how's it going? So in today's video, we are going to take a look at this thin and light laptop. This is ThinkPad X1 Carbon Gen 9, and this is powered by Intel's 11th generation Core i7 and Core i5 processor. So specifically, this model that I have, it's Core i7 1185G7, and there is another Core i5 model that is 1135G7. So both these models, I have listed them in the video description below. You can click on those links to get more details. So in today's video, I want to focus on the CPU performance of this laptop. I want to see how good these 11th generation Intel Tiger Lake processors are in this thin and light form factor. So this is a really thin and light laptop. I mean, it weighs next to nothing. It's very sleek. So I want to see how much I can push the processors. So in order to do that, what I have done is I have installed DaVinci Resolve, which is a very popular video editing software. And I've got a couple of 4K files that I got from my camera. So we are going to do some basic editing on this laptop. Now, of course, this laptop does not come with a discrete GPU, so you don't have like an NVIDIA GPU. So we cannot really do very advanced video encoding and, you know, fancy color editing, color grading and all those things, because that's not possible on an integrated GPU like the Intel Iris Xe graphics. But basic editing, which mostly relies on the CPU horsepower, that we can test out in today's video. So without further ado, let's get started. I have these two files here. And one thing that I have done is that I have already selected these two files here and generated something called optimized media. So you right click here and you generate optimized media. Now I had to do this because like I mentioned, since this laptop does not have a discrete GPU, if you directly edit 4K files on a laptop which doesn't have a discrete GPU, there will be a lot of stutters. And one of the reasons why this happens is because I'm using the free version of DaVinci Resolve. So the free version of DaVinci Resolve actually does not utilize hardware acceleration. So it will be unfair of me to basically, you know, run H.264 files on this laptop on a free version of DaVinci Resolve. Now, if you have the studio license, then it will utilize the Intel Iris Xe graphics and you will get better performance. But for today's video, let's use the optimized media. So in my playback here, I have selected optimized media. So one of the options here, playback, I have this selected, used optimized media if available, and I have generated it. So I want to show you first of all how the video plays. So with the optimized media turned on, you can see the scrubbing is very smooth. Now, if I go and turn off the optimized media, and if I try to scrub, you can see that it's stuttering. It's not butter smooth. It's doable, actually. You can still do it. So, for example, I drop it in the timeline, and if I play, so here's the video playing, and during the normal playback at 100 percent speed, there are no frames getting dropped. So it's good. But if I try to drag the, and try to like scrub it, that's when I start seeing some, choppy behavior. So if you don't want to see that, go here and select optimized media. So now with the optimized media selected, you can see it's butter smooth. So that's what we will do here. So this is nice. So far, so good. Let's look at the performance here. My CPU is running at 2.8 gigahertz. The base clock frequency is 3 gigahertz and it's right around that. So it's not throttling. GPU is pretty much not being used. Like I said before, because I'm using the free version of DaVinci Resolve, it's not really going to use the video decode and video encode engine. Let me also bring in the hardware monitor. We will monitor the temperatures. So right now the processor is running at around 60 degrees Celsius. So that's not bad. That's actually reasonable. Okay, so now let's do some basic editing. So, the typical stuff you will be doing is, cutting, for example. So you might be scrubbing through your files, maybe cutting like this, deleting some parts. So that is actually happening very smoothly. I can drag the files, no problem. Let's do some basic titles. So maybe I want to put a title here. Let's double click here. So I will say demo. And the second one I will say demo video. So let's see if it renders that without any issues. Yeah, so that's easy. Let's add some effects. So I will go to video transition. Let's put blur dissolve on this. So it does the blur dissolve, no problem. So this was a basic effect, so that it did without any issues. Now I want to do some more fancy title effect. So let's try the Fusion title. So Fusion title uses the GPU, and I'm willing to make a bet this one is going to struggle. So I think this will be a good test. Let's see if it is able to render this effect. Actually, that was, yeah, I see some stuttering. I don't know if you guys noticed. And let me make this bigger. So what it is doing is, in real time, it's actually rendering this portion of the file. As you can see, those red dots are, so yeah, now when it's completely blue, that means it has completely rendered it. That was actually fast. I'm impressed. So now when I play, it should go smoothly. Yeah, that was smooth. So yeah, that's good. So that means the processor is doing a good job. Let's see how the temperatures are. Okay, so it did reach 100 degrees Celsius for a while, but went back to 68, 69, so not bad. Let's see the CPU, what clock it's running. Still running close to base clock frequency. Well, I actually saw a turbo boost, so yeah, 3.2 gigahertz. So the CPU is actually doing well. So that's one of the things that I wanted to test, that when you actually push the CPU, does the CPU start throttling? If I put my hands here, it is getting warm. It is definitely getting warm. But here at the center of the keyboard and where my trackpad is, it's very comfortable. But near the hinge, I can feel the, you know, the laptop getting warm. And so again, I'm not surprised because we are really pushing it. Guys, this is 4K video files and we are utilizing only the CPU, because like I said, the free version of the DaVinci Resolve is not going to use the CPU, the GPU that much. So the CPU is really getting taxed here. What else should we do? Let's do some color grading. So I will pause the video here. Let's go to color tab. So this is where you do all the color grading. Let's mess with the gain. So if I increase the gain, see, the video becomes brighter. So maybe I want to increase the brightness by, say, 15%. That looks a little brighter. So if you want your videos to pop out, you can mess with the gain here. You also have various color tabs. So if I want my video to be a little bluish, maybe, you know, higher color temperature, I can do that. Like a more tungsten feel, you know, like Matrix. Or I can make it green. So like when you are inside the Matrix, it's everything is green. So yeah, let's, that's a little green tinge here. Yeah, kind of like that. See, that's the Matrix. That's how you look in the Matrix. So when you are in the real world, it's green. So let me put a cut here. And then from this point onward, I'm inside the Matrix. And so I will be blue. So let's make it slightly blue like that. Yeah. And we can put a transition here so that you have this fancy transition when you move from green to blue. So what kind of transition would we do? Effects, video transition. Let's do a blur dissolve. We'll put this here. Okay. So if I play the video now, so I am green here. So this is inside the Matrix. And there you go, and you become blue. So that was seamless. So that seems to be doing good. Now let's take a look at the temperatures. Still around 70 degrees Celsius. The max temperature, I see few cores went all the way to 100 degrees Celsius. So it did get hot, but then, you know, the, let's see the frequency. Well, so the frequency is still good, 3.3 gigahertz. It's actually turbo boosting right now. So the performance is good and it's still actually comfortable. The keyboard here is comfortable. The trackpad, everything feels comfortable except the hinge here. This hinge is getting warm. Let's see how good it will perform when we actually render the files. So what I'm going to do is I will render in MP4, H.264. I will render in, let's first try 4K. Let's see if it can render in 4K. So I'll call the file 4K, add to the queue, go on, and let's start the render. Okay, so we are rendering the file. Let's see the CPU here. So CPU is now 100% running at turbo boost, 3.3 gigahertz. So that's good. Let's look at the temperatures. The temperature is, oh, it's getting hot, guys. It's 98, 95. So around 95 degrees Celsius. And the frequency is now dropping. So it's now running at 2.4 gigahertz. So basically we have heated up all the cores. And so now the CPU is downclocking itself. The temperature is now around 90 degrees. And yeah, it feels warm. It definitely feels warm. The hinge is actually quite warm. But if you are using the keyboard here, the keyboard is still comfortable. So it's almost like the heat sink is probably here on near the hinge. So that's where, you know, the, all the heat is being dissipated from here. So now I see the CPU has dropped its clock frequency to 0.4 gigahertz. So I think it got hot and it dropped the clock frequency. So that doesn't look very good. Okay, so the CPU now, for a while, the CPU, as you can see here, it dropped its frequency and it's now back up again to 2.9 gigahertz. So at this part, I guess it got too hot and it, downclocked itself. I think as far as the thermal heat management on this laptop is concerned, I do see the CPU throttling. So it's not perfect. I'm taking it to the extreme, but I do see the CPU throttling. See, again, the CPU clock frequency is now gone to 0.39 gigahertz. It has really downclocked itself because it was getting hot. Actually, the temperature right now is 70 degrees Celsius. It's not that hot, but boy, the CPU is running very slow right now. It's actually running at 0.39 gigahertz. It's 300. Okay, now it's back to 2.7 gigahertz. So that's a little concerning. I mean, the CPU is throttling here. So we are rendering a 4K video file and I'm running the DaVinci Resolve free version. So all the workload is being done by the CPU. It's not using the GPU at all. In fact, if I go here in the GPU, you can see the video encode and video decode. Those two guys are sitting at 0%. It is using the 3D pipe of GPUs, so that it is utilizing. I guess this is for, all the color correction and, the title transition. For all those effects, GPU is being used. Actually, now GPU usage is at 90%. So I guess it's running one of those transitions that we created. And right now the CPU usage has dropped. But I do see the CPU get almost as hot as 100 degrees Celsius, which is quite hot in my opinion. And when it does that, it does drop the frequency. It actually goes all the way to 0.4 gigahertz. That's 400 megahertz. So the CPU is definitely getting hot, which means the thermal management here is probably not very good. I think, I don't know if this particular unit is defective or if it's the case with all the other laptops. I don't know. So let's take a look at how fast it is going. It's around 10 frames per second, the rendering. So this video is shot at 24 frames per second and it's rendering at 10 frames per second. Let me stop this because this is a very long video. I don't want to sit here and, wait for it to complete. Now what I will do is I will render this file again, but this time I will render it in 1080p and let's see how, how good the laptop performs when we are rendering in 1080p. Render a 1080p file. I will call it 1080p. Add to render. And let's start. Okay, so now you can see the speed has bumped up to 20, oh, 35, 40, oh, that's good, 38. Okay, so it's going up and down, but it's definitely going faster than 24 frames per second, which is good. Let's see how the CPU is performing. Now the CPU is not running at 100%, it's actually running at 67 to 70%. GPU is around 32%. And how are our temperatures? Temperatures are about 78 to 80 degrees, and the clock speed is around 2 gigahertz. So let's see if the CPU throttles when we render a 1080p files. So you guys may remember during 4K video editing, we had the CPU throttle, and let's see if that is something that happens with 1080p files. So far it looks good. The CPU is running at a steady 2.1, yeah, about 2.1 gigahertz, and the temperatures are around 79 to 80 degrees Celsius. So it's not throttling. So this looks good. So I think if you're editing 1080p files on this laptop, you are fine. But if you edit 4K files, then the CPU starts throttling. And you have the CPU run at 3 gigahertz for a while, then it drops to almost like 0.4 gigahertz. It'll cool, it again goes back to the base clock frequency. So throttling happens in 4K video editing. In 1080p, I'm not seeing any throttling. Okay, so I think I will stop this here. Let's go back to our final temperature analysis. So it's around 75 degrees Celsius, and the CPU is okay. So we stopped the job, so obviously the CPU usage has gone down. So yeah, that's it guys. I think I will wrap up this video here. I just wanted to show you the performance of this laptop when you really push it. So we found a couple of things, interesting things I would say. If you are editing 4K videos on this laptop, I think you will push the CPU to its limit. It gets heated to about 100 degrees Celsius and then it starts throttling. So that's something which actually I'm not happy because I honestly don't want my laptop to throttle under any condition. This guy is getting hot, so that means probably Lenovo, in order to make this laptop really thin and light, they have probably made some compromises with respect to fans. Now, the fans are running full throttle, So the fans are actually doing their best to cool down the laptop, but I guess it's still getting hot enough that the CPU starts throttling. Now, I don't know if this is only this particular unit which is throttling or if it's the case with everybody else. If any of you guys, if you own one of the ThinkPad X1 Carbon laptops, specifically Generation 9, let me know if the, you know, if you have seen the CPU throttle when you are running a job where, you know, the CPU usage is 100%. And the second thing that we learned is that, you know, near the hinge, the laptop is definitely getting hot. So it's going to be a little warm near the hinge, but the keyboard area is still fine. So I think I will wrap up this video, guys. Let me know what you guys think about this laptop. Full review of this laptop, I'm still working on its full review, so that I will drop hopefully in a couple of weeks. So stay tuned if you are interested in, you know, watching the full review of this laptop. And if you want me to cover any particular thing, any other aspect of this laptop, please drop it in the comment section below and I will try to incorporate it in my full review. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you found this video useful or entertaining, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.